Rosanna, the artist behind Bikinage Crochet, and in today's video I'm going to be showing you how to add fabric to a piece of crochet. So in this one I've added a skirt to my top of my dress here. So let's get started. Here's my crochet bodice, and I'm going to add the skirt to the bottom. Now, first of all, I need to calculate the width of the fabric I'm going to need. So use my tape measure, and my piece of crochet is 27 centimeters on the front, so I need to double that to have the back as well, so it's 54 centimeters in total. Now, for this garment, it's for my daughter, so she needs a lot of fabric around because she's still wearing nappies, so I'm going to double this amount and it will come up to 108. So it's going to be 108 for the width. Now for the length, I know I want my length to be 32 centimeters. So my calculation so far is 108 for the width, 32 for the length. Now I need to add in a few little measurements now. So add 3 centimeters to your length. So, and add 2 centimeters to your width. So overall, my piece of fabric for this dress is going to be 110 and 35 centimeters. Now this is for a child's dress. If I'm making a top or a dress myself, I would change the multiplication to be 1.5, not 2 lengths of the circumference. Okay, so here's my fabric. Now this is the second time I am doing this video, so I've already done a few of the steps. But so here's my fabric. It's 110 in width and 35 in length. Okay. To start with, put the two right sides together. The right sides are the sides that you're going to see. Okay, so put them together and you're going to sew along from 1 centimeter from the edge. So here you can see I've already sewn here. Now, to keep this a nice clean edge, you have a choice. You can overlock with your sewing machine and use an overlocking foot. Or if you don't want to, you can use some pinking shears, which create a zigzag stitch along the edge, which will stop it fraying. Okay, so I've gone off and I've ironed my crease. Now we're going to sew along this 1 centimeter from the edge. And here is my seam done. So I've got a nice clean hem for the bottom of my skirt. Okay, now what we're going to do is the gather. So you're going to go back to the top of your piece of fabric. And here's my top of my fabric. And you're going to use the widest stitch possible you have on your sewing machine. And you're going to go 2 centimeters from your center seam, all the way round to 2 centimeters on the other side. So you can do this 0.5 centimeter from the top, so it's very close to the top. And the most important thing, you need long tails on the beginning and at the end. So I've gone all the way around on my longest stitch on my sewing machine, which is a 5, so that means every 0.5 centimeter it's made a stitch. Now to show you, I've also done it in a different color to make it clear. So this is line 1, now you're going to repeat this process 1 centimeter from the edge. Now I've done 2 lines, you should be able to see this clearly, and I've got my long tails from my thread. Now remove one of these pins and put it directly on the other side, so that's your halfway mark. So we've got a mark from the halfway front and the halfway back. Okay, so here is where we gather. So pull 2 of the top strings and you're going to gently gather these like this. It's a very gentle, delicate process. Don't pull too hard because you will snap your threads. And you're just going to go gently all the way around until you get your gather. Now you're going to turn your piece inside out, well, right side out, because because we've been working on the inside. And that's our skirt so far. So our lines, one for the front and one for the back. This is for me to easily align my crochet piece to my skirt and get an even gather. So what I'm going to do is pin one from the back and pin one from the front, and I'm going to pin all the way around and create a gather to my size. So if I need to stretch it, I can. If I need to make it a bit smaller, I just pull on the threads. Okay, so now I've pinned all the way around, and I've put loads of pins in here because I don't want to miss my fabric on my crochet when I sew around. Okay, your last thing now to sew is you're going to sew all the way around with your crochet and your fabric and go all the way around to you meet the beginning. Okay, and another tip, make sure you use the right color thread. So for me, I'm going to be using peach thread on the bottom and white thread on the back. So now I've sewn all the way around. So my skirt is now attached to my dress with a nice gather all the way around. So there we go. Now, the last thing you need to do, which takes a bit of time, is to remove the two layers of gathering stitches. Now, the best way to do this is turn your garment inside out. Maybe do this while you're watching TV, because it can take a little while. And just use some really small scissors. Or use an unpicker. I don't have mine to hand at the moment. And just make a snip every inch or so. And because they were such wide stitches, it will just pull all the way out.